20%. So it will be a little bit more active as we go through the weekend. Use our app. It downloads exactly where these storms are and alerts you if there's lightning nearby by Sunday evening around sunset, which should be dry. You can track those showers as you make your plans. All right, first thing tomorrow morning, low to mid-60s. Another comfortable start for the most part. 92 by the afternoon, pretty hot, and the humidity starts to increase. Boaters, a moderate chunk for those inland and bay waters. Here's your 7-day forecast. The red flashing box, that's for a fire alert, remains very high. Humidity stays with us next week. Temperatures only into 70s. Coming up at 6 o'clock, we'll detail out how much rain we're expecting this weekend.
NBC2 with a breaking news update. That man shot at this mall in Nashville died. The shooter is in custody. It started as a fight between two men that erupted into gunfire. The mall is right across from the iconic Grand Ole Opry.
And more breaking news right now. Christina Carolla here in the Alert Center. We're following another mall shooting. This one happened in North Carolina just minutes ago. Let's take this full screen. This is a live feed here from the chopper there. Our local affiliate, Gastonia, North Carolina. This is going on. This is a crime scene right here. Once they zoom out, you'll see the tape surrounding this area. You can see detectives there, police on scene. Reports of one person shot. Detectives are still there investigating, but obviously very early in this investigation. We'll let you know what happens here. We're trying to find out if the shooter is still at large and what's going on. Of course, if anything changes, we'll be sure to let you know. But that's the very latest here in the Alert Center.
10,000 new homes could be coming to one Southwest Florida community. This development would be called Rural Lands West.
It's planned between Golden Gate Estates and Ave Maria. Basically, it's like building a town the size of Estero. NBC just raised more to find out if this rural area is ready for that much growth.
This farm will soon look very different. There are plans to turn this land on Royal Road and Everglades Boulevard into a new community with 10,000 homes.
Ave Maria is just down the road. There's lots of construction around here. You know, I think it's great. I think a lot of people are going to be moving out here, and it's going to get a lot busier.
The Rural Lands West community will be in eastern Collier County. The area is already growing exponentially. In the last couple of years, they got their first Publix, and other restaurants are now popping up.
I actually love the estates, and it's growing, which is awesome. Now that the Publix is in, the CVS is in, it gives us things to do out here. We don't have to go all the way into town.
The Rural Lands West community is still in the permitting phases, but the developers say they expect to have some of the homes built here in 2020.
I think it's good news, yeah. I think it's going to do a lot for the community and help kind of the area of Orange Street develop.
A big concern with all those new homes is traffic. The developer says they're working with Collier County on a plan, and they expect that the community will bring in $86 million in transportation impact fees.
A lot of the road is starting to get backed up as it is. Maybe the different roads and different routes, maybe extend them a little bit, but it's going to come in due time.
Along with homes, there are plans to build restaurants, shopping, schools, and businesses out here. It's a welcome idea for those who live nearby. In Golden Gate States, Risa Morris, NBC2.
A shooting involving a Florida deputy ended with a car chase and a crash. Take a look. This all started this morning when a woman east of Orlando called 911 saying her ex-boyfriend attacked her. Deputies arrived. He tried to run one of them over, so they shot him. He then took off in his car, and as you see, finally stopped when deputies caused him to crash.
Zachary Cruz, the brother of the Parkland shooter, Nicholas Cruz, is getting some powerful legal help. Nexus Service is suing the Broward County Sheriff for violating Cruz's constitutional rights. We told you yesterday he was arrested for driving without a license, being too close to a school he doesn't
365 on Sanibel to find out what exactly in sunscreen can be so harmful.
Well, it's actually the chemicals they want banned. So scientists say unless your brand is oxybenzone-free, it belongs on this sign.
Why are you saying?
Because I don't want to get sunburned.
In Florida, sunscreen is a must.
What's a familiar name of banana boat?
But is your sunscreen killing coral reefs?
Oh, I would say, well, that's not good.
According to scientists, it's not good at all.
Yeah, a bottle of sunscreen would be enough to pollute that entire bay.
Which is why Hawaii would be the first state to ban products containing oxybenzone.
penalty, but that will be up to the state attorney in the coming months. Reporting live in St. Carlos Park, Jacqueline Bemis, NBC2.
Well, Diana's body is still missing.